California was once a place where we had a thriving commercial fishery, recreational fisheries. Those populations have dwindled over the last almost 100 years by a successive development of our water resources, dams, irrigation diversions, transportation networks in this state. The transportation network that the forest system has was built to meet our mission at the time. However, that mission is changing. And what we're now challenged with is helping those organisms that use the stream networks as their habitat to complete their life history in stream networks on forest system lands. Forest Service has quite a developed road network, transportation network, on all 18 national forests. And those were built over a series of decades and pretty much had a single objective: get vehicular traffic across the stream, you know, from point A to point B. In many cases, there wasn't a lot of thought put into streams as corridors for aquatic organisms moving through those watersheds. I've actually videotaped fish trying to reach their natal grounds where they'll spawn and being frustrated in those attempts by a culvert under a road that is either too high or too steep for them to swim through. You could have the best aquatic habitat in the world on any particular reach of stream on a national forest, but if the species that normally use that habitat can't access that habitat, then it's not fulfilling its potential. And it is difficult, challenging, actually, to witness that and realize that that's being replicated at tens of thousands of crossings across the West and thousands right here in Region 5. If you look at the data throughout the West where they have inventoried the road stream crossings, over 80% of those road stream crossings are going to present a barrier to some organism. There's a lot of variability on the cost associated with repairs. You know, low end might be tens of thousands of dollars. There are other projects where there's an existing culvert that's a barrier that need to be a bridge to really accommodate all of the species and their life stages, you know, that need access there. And bridge construction is a very expensive undertaking, usually millions of dollars each. The fade black graphic was developed by NOAA Fisheries to illustrate how the construction of dams around the Central Valley of California has affected anadromous salmonids. So that would be your Chinook salmon and steelhead in particular. And in succession, as those dams were constructed, it blacks out the upstream networks of habitat that were no longer accessible as a result of each dam. And at the end, it shows about 80% of that historic habitat as being no longer accessible. I would like to see the fade to black scenario erased. It's conceivable, it's very possible to eliminate these aquatic organism passage barriers from forest system lands. We can correct them. We can turn the corner. We can restore access to those habitats, and the species will respond. Thank you.